If you watch George's channel at all, then you know he loves street rods. He loves Australian vehicles. And of course, movie and TV cars and trucks. So I guess I shouldn't have been all that surprised when he picked this car. An Australian car. A street rod which was featured so predominantly in the Mad Max movies. Now that there is intersectionality that even a liberal Democrat would love. It's considered a full-size vehicle down under, but if you see some of the land yachts that the big three were making here in the U.S. back in the day, you know this is really an intermediate or a mid-size car. It has more in common with a Torino than an LTD. Its wheelbase is actually 100 millimeters shorter than the U.S. offered mid-size. Aussie Ford produced this second-gen Falcon for 3 years, producing 211,000 units in that time. Hot Wheels produced this from 2010 to 2016. WikiFandom says it's a representation of the rare Falcon XB GT. Other than the inaugural colors of yellow and Apollo blue with a GT351 tampo on the front fender, I'm not sure how this depicts one Falcon XB over another. It's a 1/64th toy after all. After the first year, they can be found in a variety of colors. This orange was issued in 2014. I had no clue what I was going to do. Certainly not Mad Max's car. I'll think of something, though. So stick around.
Yeah. Come down off your throne and leave your body alone. Somebody must change. You are the reason I've been waiting so long. Somebody holds the key. Well, I'm weary, yeah. Just ain't got the time. And I'm wasted and can't find my way home. Come down on your own and leave your body low. Somebody must change. You are the reason I've been waiting all these years. Somebody holds the key. I'm wasted and I can't find my way home.
So I said it wasn't going to be Max's car, and it's not. But what's a guy to do, eh? I could have made it a street rod. Something like that is going down the easy path for me. Or I could step outside the box and do something I've never done before. One thing Aussies do, mate, is survive the apocalypse. I have to thank Jim Silva, who sent me the pieces and bits I used on this. Google doesn't do very well with little-scale weapons. It's an interesting genre of diecast that is, of course, very popular. I've just never done one. There will be a short episode of The Bench to follow the video if you like that kind of thing. This is TimeRider, and I'll leave the light on for you. Hey, thanks for hanging around for this episode of The Bench. So, was somebody just talking about land yachts? Next month, Paul picked matchbox number MB1172, the 75 Chevy Caprice. I saw this on the list, and I cursed Paul. Then the light bulb went on, and I knew exactly what I wanted to do with it, and that was months ago. It'll be good, trust me. Of course, we're getting close to the Paint It Pink build in October. It's a great cause. It's always fun as well to see what everyone does. If you want to be a part of the Three Blind Mice recap video, let us know at threeblindmicediecast@gmail.com. I had someone ask, so we'll make it clear. If you do not have YouTube videos or a YouTube channel, that's fine. You don't have to be a part of this. Send photos to our email. Hell, if you do videos and you want to send glamour shot photos, we'll take those too. If you don't see your name sliding across the screen right now, let us know and we'll be sure to add you to our list. So I had told y'all last week that I was going to be doing a build on October 10th with Dad and Andrew's garage. Well, the story goes like this. I had these two castings and I was going to send one to them, and they're in Canada and already had the casting, so they just decided to use their own. Well, that left me with another Chevelle, and so Matchbox Mark is going to be joining our October build. So look forward to that. The picture today is a wasteland here at home I took in 2013. It was in a folder called Arizona, but it could have been New Mexico just as easily. I hope you enjoyed the video and it finds you healthy, happy, and wise.